doing. Yeah, it's kind of tough growing up in the streets of Philly and Germantown. Growing up around the corner from the projects, having to fight my way to get to school. You get caught walking around the street by the guys from the projects, you want to get jumped. You got to fight all the time. I was fighting my way out of Philly. Man, it's tough. It's a tough city. We didn't have that much money. I just found out that when I was younger, I was sleeping with was a closet when I was a little boy, so it was a struggle for me and my mom. I stayed on the street. She had to work two jobs, so she was never home. So there was nobody telling me what to do. So I got in all types of trouble. And I think something clicked when I was younger and one of my friends got shot at the corner. I said, I gotta change my ways. I gotta get out of here. I gotta change some things. So I started getting into sports a little bit more. Ended up going to Dobbins High School.
Yeah.
Playing ball at Dobbins. My father wasn't around. Even though he was somewhat of a successful football player. But he still wasn't around for me. So the person that kind of took me under his wing was my high school coach, Doug McCauley. He must have saw the talent that I had. High school, you know, people tell you, if you're not getting straight A's and B's, you're not going to college. So that was beat into my head so much that I just started working at McDonald's and thinking, that's where I'm gonna be at. I don't have straight A's and B's. So my mind was focused on, you know, playing football. There's a 10% chance that you could make it to the NFL. If you can't get straight A's and B's, you're not going to college. I don't have any money. I'm working at McDonald's. I'm ready to start my family. I just had a daughter. Then I started putting in extra work, and I didn't want to listen to what everybody told me. And I think it was 10th grade, I said, I'm going to step it up a notch. So one summer I just started walking. I used to live in Germantown. My friend lived up here in North Philly, probably 13th and Jefferson. I would walk almost every day, but if I can't take a bus, I will walk from Germantown to North Philly to work out and train with my friend over the summer. Nobody told me to do it, but you know, I had some dreams, I had goals that I wanted to achieve. I wasn't gonna listen to, you know, what people were telling me, what teachers were telling me in high school. So I ended up starting to get letters from colleges, which were kind of a shock to me, but I put in that extra work, and I ended up getting a bunch of offers from colleges. I ended up picking Temple. So the crazy thing is, I picked Temple. There's a bunch of Penn State teachers, graduates at my high school, they came into my room and stopped my class. Said, are you stupid? You picked Temple over Penn State, Syracuse, Michigan State? They stopped my class. Like, it was three Penn State graduates that came into my class and stopped my class. And said, are you stupid? But I had my daughter, I wanted to stay close to home. It was a sacrifice I was willing to take. And I knew Fox Business School was one of the best in the country. So, got that scholarship to Temple. Temple was kind of tough, you know. We didn't win that many games. never give up. You just gotta put in hard work. I would never quit. But I mean, it was a crazy. I mean, it was people driving past our practices, shooting in the air. It's like, this is crazy. But I mean, I try to stay focused. You know, I gotta go to class, and I'm in a big lecture hall, and the professor's talking bad about us. Like, football team? Who cares about the football team? I gotta sit in the back with my head down. So that was tough. But I mean, it taught me hard work pays off. Hard work, dedication, consistency. And I pushed myself to the limit. I would run and push myself to the limit. Some tears come out of my eyes sometimes. Because that's how bad I wanted it. And then I get drafted by the Eagles. I get drafted by the Eagles in the seventh round, which is the last round. Almost didn't get drafted. But growing up in Philly, who wouldn't want to play for the home team? I was in a high, like the highest high that you could think of, not that high. I was high. You know, I went in there to practice. I was standing out. I was over there with all my guys I looked up to. Hugh Douglas, Corey Simon, all those guys. Trey Thomas, you know, Runyon. I mean, everybody was there. It was great. I was excited. You know, I was practicing well. Then I got a phone call. Said, they don't want to pay you $15,000, your signing bonus. It's like, what? It's like, yeah. My agent said, you gotta leave, you gotta get your money. I said, all right. So I asked to be released. I ended up going to Indianapolis with Tony Dungy. And it was tough, because I went from my highest to the high, to the lowest. Like, my heart was broke. I was so depressed, I would mope around. I'm holding a bag at practice and just bad body language. It's terrible. Like, I'm just ready to quit. I had seven people in front of me. I wasn't second team, I wasn't third team. I was holding a bag. But coach came to me one time and said, if you don't snap out of it, I'm gonna cut you. You need to snap out of it, pull me to the side. Because I was just moping around. And then the switch just hit, and I just started laying people out. And I just started, all that energy, all that the stress and everything just started, just pushed me to a whole new level, and I just started laying people out. And I had, four draft picks that were drafted in front of me. One was my bro, Dwight Freeney, who was the first draft pick. And then it was two other draft picks that got drafted the same year as me. And by the end of camp, I was able to beat all those guys out and restart for the Indianapolis Colts. Never give up. You got thick skin. You know, they said if you can make it out of Philly, you can make it anywhere.
Word.
I believe that.
Word.
It's a tough city, man. So I'm in Indianapolis. I'm starting. I came back to Philly that year. We beat the mess out of Philly. No offense to the Eagles fans. I'm still a fan. I ended up having a great 8 years playing for one of the winningest teams in that decade. And starting all those years playing in two Super Bowls and only winning one Super Bowl. We had tough games, some classic games playing against the Patriots. yeah, I made a lot of, that hard work. You know, Tony Dungy's a great coach. I was able to play with some great leaders, some great Hall of Fame players. Peyton Manning, Reggie Wayne, Marvin Harrison, Edgar James, Gary Brackett. I mean, I could go on. You know, some great guys on that team. You know, a seventh round draft pick, I'm not supposed to be in that situation, but that hard work and dedication. And then Tony Dungy says, attention to detail. You always have to pay attention to detail and preparation. So I took that along with me too. And I ended up going to Seattle after leaving Indianapolis, playing with the Marshawn and those guys over there and Pete Carroll. And, you know, it was fun. I enjoyed it. And I was able to talk to the younger guys and try to motivate them. I knew what they had going. I knew they was going to get a Super Bowl eventually. They had everything in place. My first time experiencing an earthquake created by a guy running the ball, peacefully. it was an experience. But I was able to go to Seattle, finish off my career, being one of the best pass rushers in the league. I mean, that was one of my dreams. I also wanted to make Pro Bowl, but I wasn't able to do that. But I was able to finish off being one of the best in the league that year. And with all that, I was able to, with the success that I've had playing ball, I was able to come back home, start my foundation. I've been giving scholarships to the kids at my high school at Dobbins.
Word.
Working with my old elementary school, you know, I donate to them. Take the kids Christmas shopping. Brought the whole football team from Dobbins out to a game in Indianapolis, showed them around the locker room. And, you know, I just blessed to be able to do that. You know, not a lot of people were able to do that, to come back and just
work,
get back. And I wanted to
work.
Show them that, you know, anything's possible, because I had family, friends, teachers telling me that I couldn't make it. And if that's beat into your head enough, you're going to believe it, because I did at one point. But I was able to defy a lot of odds, and I'm still doing it, still trying to. And my journey's not over yet. But giving back to the community is one of the things I do. I do a lot of investing now, but I mean, the community thing is, I love doing that, giving back to the kids.